Max Weather Chief Meteorologist Van Denton and Meteorologist Charles Ewing, they have been in the Fox 8 Max Weather Center all day. Van, just an unbelievable afternoon. We were expecting some severe weather. Unfortunately, it did come to fruition.
Yeah, I was hoping it would just get by and not be as bad, but it turned out to be pretty rough for all of us. You can see what's been going on across the area this afternoon with the severe weather. This shows you the green and the red together with time across Guilford County, and the rotation maxed out at 132 miles per hour as just west of Pleasant Garden, it really started to spin up as it went through the southeast side of Greensboro. This is the maximum we found, which is between Market and Phillips, just along and east of 29. But all along this particular path, we had some strong winds that continued, and we actually saw this thing continue on up into Rockingham County. We had tornado warnings issued there. Blacksburg has not put out any confirmation of tornado touchdown, but I know in the news we had some reports of certainly a good possibility, but we did get the reports that are confirmed again throughout Guilford County, at least five different touchdowns by the tornado. The first one being this one that was at 5:06 with numerous trees and power lines reported down along with debris around I-40 to 421, and it just continued up through the east side of Greensboro. Let's go over to Charles Ewing now to show you that things are getting a lot better outside at the moment.
Yeah, that sure are, Van. Things are now beginning to quiet down across our area, but down into the Raleigh-Durham area, you see some of the more active activity with lots of strong to severe thunderstorms for them. But for us, for tonight, I think you will be able to go to bed without worrying about your NOAA weather radio going off. Just take a look at the radar here. Most of the powerful thunderstorms now down in the Raleigh-Durham area. Back behind it, we have rain, heavy to moderate at times, but as we continue to go back like toward the Wilkes County area, the rain now really beginning to slacken off. I just wanted to widen out and show you this view. We have no warnings for us. All the warnings are now down in the Raleigh-Durham area. See that little red box to the south of Richmond? That's a tornado warning for our friends, let's say, across the central parts of Virginia. But again, we're not looking at any warnings for us here in the Piedmont Triad. Future clouds and radar showing us the powerful thunderstorms moving down east. By the time you wake up on your Monday morning, look for cloudy to partly cloudy skies. And yep, we could even see some snow at the very high elevations in the mountains on Monday. Back at home for your Monday afternoon, look for cloudy to partly cloudy skies. Very breezy conditions. Also, you notice it will be a lot cooler for you Monday with high temperatures only in the 50s. Now, for your Tuesday morning, I am watching Tuesday morning, not for severe weather, but maybe for the possibility of frost. It will turn very cold, but if the winds stay up, we shouldn't have to worry about any frost. So let's keep our fingers crossed. Hopefully the winds will keep on blowing for your Tuesday morning and into our Tuesday afternoon, still on the breezy side with sunny to partly cloudy skies. And it looks like the warming trend will kick in a little bit for our Tuesday. But for tonight, anyway, the storms ending, pulling out, going down to around 49 degrees. And for your tomorrow, a mix of southern clouds and breezy with a high of only 57 degrees. Now, here's a look at your 5-day forecast. There's that Tuesday morning I'm keeping a very close eye on, 36 degrees. Then you see the warming trend for our Wednesday, then cooling off again by the time we hit Friday, sunny skies with a high of only 63 degrees.